What's good, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk back again with another video for you guys. Hit that subscribe button, the bell, the like, all that good stuff. But let's get right into this. We got a topic today that's something you hear all about, you know, in today's society. And, you know, as you see, this NFL player rated the top offensive lineman in the NFL, Brandon Brooks, missed the game Sunday for the Eagles. I mean, he played in like 12 snaps, but you might as well say he missed the game. And, you know, the team had said it was an illness, but he came out later, you know, because people were wondering. He's on the sideline, he's playing in 12 snaps, and he's off. They're like, what's going on with this guy? It's an illness, it's not an injury. And, you know, he comes out and says it was anxiety. He was having anxiety attacks and such. And, you know, you can go out and check. He spoke to the press about it after the game, but I'm going to go over some of the stuff that he said. But, you know, go listen to it for yourself. You know, and the team ended up losing 17 to 9 to the Seattle Seahawks. And, you know, this dude, like I said, top rated lineman in the league. At one point, a couple weeks ago, I don't know if it's still this way, he hadn't even given up a sack. You know what I mean? So him not being there hurt the team, right? And he comes out and says this. He says, I'd like to address what happened yesterday. This is via his Twitter. I woke up and did my typical routine of morning vomiting. It didn't go away like it normally does, but I figured it would calm down once I got to the stadium. It did, but I felt exhausted. The nausea came back and I tried to battle through it and went out for the first drive. The nausea and vomiting came back until I left the field and tried everything I could to get back for my teammates, but just wasn't able to do it. Make no mistake, I'm not ashamed or embarrassed by this, nor what I go through daily. I've had this under control for a couple of years and had a setback yesterday. The only thing I'm upset about is that when my team needed me, I wasn't able to be out there with them, with and for them. Lastly, I appreciate the support of my coaches, teammates, and fans. It doesn't go unnoticed. So that's kind of wild, man. You hear, he says his normal morning routine of vomiting. Like, that's wild, you know what I mean? To wake up every day. And, you know, he's obviously associating this with his anxiety. He spoke about this for a few years, you know what I mean? He's one of the few players who's come out. We've seen players speak about mental illness, you know, but specifically speaking about anxiety. And, you know, it's been a battle for him, and he thought he had it under control, and he had like a relapse. And some of the stuff that he talked about, you know, he just signed a big contract extension. You know, they got him locked up till 2024. Locked down, I should say. Locked up's not the right word. But, you know, it's just kind of wild. You know, people think of athletes as being superhuman and things of that nature. And, you know, obviously, everyone really knows we're all just people. But they get looked at a little differently, just like other celebrities, because, you know, their life is in the news all the time. And it's a lot that they gotta live up to. And it feels like nowadays, you know what I mean, anxiety is taking over our society. You know what I mean? Comment if you guys have had an anxiety attack before, or if you battle anxiety. But this is what I'm trying to say, is I'm a firm believer in, you know, the power of the mind. You know what I mean? Like, you can overthink things. And that's what this guy's talking about. He's thinking about not letting his team down. Not, you know, is he going to live up to this contract? Is he a disappointment and things of that nature? And there's athletes sometimes who make it to the pros, right? They were great in college. They get in the pros and they don't live up to expectations. They just don't look like the same player. Now, sometimes it's just, you know, things out there with the game, they don't adjust and stuff like that. But a lot of times, I'm a firm believer, it's about, you know, the power of the mind. You can overthink things. Like, tap in the comments if you guys know what I mean, as to where something that you're trying to do, if you think too much about it. I'm the type of person, sometimes I'm analyzing things in my head, even, you know, like just randomly, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not even trying to, but I do. And that's not good. You know what I mean? Everyone has got to find a way to center themselves, clear their mind. And that's what I mean. Nowadays, it seems like anxiety's taken over because it's spoke about so much. You know what I mean? Like, you think about it so much, or you're going through some things in life, and then someone's like, oh, yo, maybe you're depressed or you got anxiety. And you know what I'm saying? And then we got, you start thinking that and it gets in your head. And, you know, we also got devices, this digital internet world we live in. You're constantly looking at screens, straining your eyes. Some people can't go to sleep without, you know, something playing on their device, and getting that proper sleep is a big deal. You feel me? So what I'm trying to say is, you know, anxiety is a real thing, but it's, you know, medicine isn't always the answer. Some people do need meds, you know, for mental health and different things like that. But I'm just saying, if you can beat it without the medicine, you're always better, because you change the chemistry of your brain up, your body can be dependent on it, or even if just not dependent with withdrawals and things like that, you just change the chemistry of your body, of yourself, you know what I mean? And I don't know, I respect this dude. I'm glad that his coaches and teammates got his back, you know what I mean? Years back, people might have looked at this guy and say, yo, are you kidding me? What are you, a punk? Like, you're missed. Come on, get out here. You know what I mean? And this guy's puking. He's nervous. His stomach's messed up because he's going through it. That's a real thing. That's what I'm saying. I'm not trying to downplay what anxiety is. I'm just saying things are out there so much. It's just a different world we live in nowadays. And sometimes it seems like anxiety is taking over. But, you know, we're seeing this, like, this is on the NFL level. You know what I mean? This is a guy in the pros. He couldn't play. He couldn't get out there because he didn't have control of, you know, what was going on with his anxiety. And that's a lot. That's a lot right there. That's heavy. Now, like I was saying, how back in the day people might have called this dude a punk or something like that. You know what I mean? That is what's good, is that nowadays people come out and say, you know, they're not afraid to get help. And I'm glad that's something that he spoke about, why he came out and spoke to the media, and he was honest and open about this. You know what I mean? Because they just, like I said, they just were like, yo, it's an illness. He's the one that came out and said, listen, it was a mental illness. It was my anxiety. I thought I had it under control. You know what I'm saying? That statement that he put out on Twitter that I read to you, the different things that he told the media, he was like, yo, I couldn't keep it together. And, you know, I'm sorry to my teammates, but I say this so other people aren't afraid to get help. You know what I mean? And, you know, they know they're not the only ones going through this, and that's real. I respect that. You know what I mean? A lot of people back in the days would never talk to someone. There's still people like that nowadays, but I feel like people can be more open nowadays. You know what I mean? That, like, they're stressed or whatever. You know what I mean? People would feel like less of a man. But as I said, you got to look at it from both ways. You know what I mean? It's good that it's out there and people are open about it, but at the same time, sometimes people can overthink things, you know what I'm saying, and develop anxiety because they're thinking about if they got anxiety. And then, like I said, them anxiety meds and all that stuff, I say, yo, you know, I'm not a professional to offer you guys help or anything. I'm just sharing, you know, my thoughts and stuff like that. And if you guys are new to my channel, like I said, make sure to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Always get in the comments. My channel is all about hearing from the people. The comments is an open thread where we debate, talk, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Everyone keeps it respectful. That's about the only rule. You know what I mean? Keep it respectful. But getting in your head, thinking about this things too much is never good. So as always with everything, you know, you got to find that happy medium. You know what I mean? Not overthinking things. It's with anything. You know, there's an extreme level of things. And then, you know, you got to find in the medium, you know, but just wanted to share this. As I said, as you guys, if you, you know, watch my channel, you know, I'm an NFL fan, and, you know, I thought this was newsworthy that their star player missed a game because he was anxiety ridden and he couldn't get out, you know what I mean? But get in the comments, let me know what you guys think about this. Thanks for tuning in. It's Jay Coffee Talk. Like, subscribe. Let's get this conversation going in the comments. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.